ScriptRunner for Confluence allows users to create fully custom scripts by using the Groovy scripting language. Groovy is a dynamic, Java-based language that, when used with ScriptRunner, allows for detailed automations, customizations, and extensions. Before we start getting into the building blocks of Groovy scripting, it's helpful to have a basic understanding of the language's syntax. There can be many parts to a block of Groovy code, but the main elements include the following. Keywords are words that have special meaning and cannot be used as variables or functions. They are fixed, specific to Groovy, and can become identifiers when combined with a dot. Apache's Groovy documentation lists the available keywords. Identifiers are variables and functions. They must start with a letter, dollar sign, or underscore. Variables include both native variables and created variables, defined by the def keyword. Strings are a series of characters grouped together with quotation marks. You can use single, double, or triple quotes for a string. And comments can be added to your code by using two forward slashes at the beginning of a single line comment. If the comment needs to span multiple lines, then a forward slash and asterisk should start the comment, and then an asterisk and forward slash should end the comment. Here's an example of a simple block of Groovy code using ScriptRunner to find and replace text on pages across an entire space. The yellow text represents the keywords, such as import, def, and the if statement. Identifiers are represented by white text, such as target space and pagebody.replace. The green text represents strings, since they are grouped together with quotation marks. And the purple text represents booleans that indicate truth values. Maya's team at Great Adventure has hundreds of pages of documentation that references using Jira Service Desk. She needs to update the name to Jira Service Management. To do this manually, it would take a lot of time. Instead, she reaches out to her Confluence administrator to see if there's an automated way to complete the task. Violet can use a custom script in ScriptRunner for Confluence to automate the task. Let's take a look at the script she uses and break down each part. The first four lines use the import keyword to import a code library from Jira or other developer APIs. Details on the different code libraries for Jira can be found in Atlassian's developer documentation. Lines 6 through 8 use the def keyword to define the original text, replacement text, and space where the replacement needs to be done. The original text and replacement text are written as a string between two single quotation marks. The space ID is also written as a string between two single quotation marks to indicate where the find and replace should occur. Lines 10 through 14 define additional variables to simplify the section of the script that prepares for the find and replace. For example, the variable space pages is defined as the pageManager.getPages identifier. Then, on line 16, the script references the space pages variable rather than the entire identifier and its values in parentheses. Line 16 begins the section where ScriptRunner finds the original text and changes it. For example, spacePages.each creates a loop that will iterate through all pages stored in the variable and execute the code per page. Then line 19 uses an if statement to tell ScriptRunner to replace the original text with the replacement text if the original text is present on a page within the defined space. Then the identifiers on lines 22 and 23 ensure the text is set up as a string and saved appropriately. To summarize, the simple block of code is separated into three sections: importing libraries of data from Confluence, defining the variables, and executing the find and replace. By knowing Groovy's basic syntax and the different parts of a ScriptRunner script, you can easily combine and modify existing scripts to get exactly what you need.